Dear students, in our last session we have seen the embedded system hardware, and in this session we will see the embedded system software. So the embedded system software contains mainly the initialization of code, where the hardware configuration, booting, diagnostics is there, operating system and applications. So first contains the hardware devices. On that hardware devices, initialization and device drivers are used, and after that operating system plays the main important role. Now operating system plays the main important role in the embedded system, and according to the need of the embedded system, the operating system has been chosen. So the categories of embedded system are, basically there are the three types of operating system. That is real-time OS, then non-real-time OS and mobile OS. So first one is non-real-time OS, means whenever the time constraint is not as much hard and time does not play any vital role, at that time the non-real-time operating system is used, when time constraint is not as much important or as much hard. Then the real-time operating system. The real-time operating system is used when time plays the important role. Whenever there is the necessity that at the perfect time the execution should be done so that no any particular disaster should happen, at that time the real-time operating systems are used. And the third one is our mobile operating system. So our laptops, mobile, smartphones, everything that contains the mobile operating system, for which the particular OS is used, which is in our devices, that are the mobile devices. So these are the three types of operating systems, and from these three operating system any one OS can be used according to our need. Now why this operating system plays the important role, and according to that applications has been developed. Applications are nothing but the function calls by using which the particular task has been executed. So why the operating system is required? Because the various functions that are provided by the operating system that are necessary. The first important function is task management. Now we have seen in our last lecture, whatever process is there or whatever job is there, that process or job is called as task in terms of the embedded system. So the task management or task execution is the main service that is provided by the operating system. Then comes the memory management. Memory also plays the important role in embedded system. According to the need of the embedded system, the particular type of memory has been chosen. Then for saving the various registers, data, the outputs, the memory is required. And for that purpose, memory management plays the important role. Because of that, we can utilize the memory. Then task synchronization and resource synchronization. As the various tasks are accessing or trying to access the same resources, then by using the task synchronization and the resource synchronization, the resources are allocated to the tasks and the tasks has been executed in a proper manner. That is also one type of service that is provided by operating system. So because of this services provided by operating system, OS plays the important role, and according to the need, the OS is chosen for the particular system. And upon that, the applications are important. Applications are nothing but the various function calls. By using that function calls, we can execute all our tasks. So that is nothing but the embedded system hardware, which mainly contains the hardware device. Because why hardware device is the part of embedded system software? Because the device drivers and initialization has been done on hardware devices. Then the operating system is used. Operating system plays the role of interface in between the hardware device and the application or the user interface. And on that system, the operating system, the applications are stored that are nothing but the function calls. So in this way, the embedded system software working has been done. Thank you.